this chapter, we got a dope dragon. Not double dragon. If you don't know what double dragon is, check the link. Dope dragon. But anyway, this is your boy, Mane. Welcome to the channel where anime and manga means more. And this time we're reviewing One Piece episode, chapter 679. Caesar go ahead and start celebrating, but Virgo notices something. He's like, why isn't G5 out there? And if they're not out there, he's like, because he knows they couldn't have gotten in. He says, the guys in the cage must have escaped. He said, we can't see the inside of the cage. You know, this is not a coincidence. A subordinate comes in and confirms that to Caesar. And Chopper, he slides off, sneaks out the way, you know, stealth point. And it looks like Monet probably noticed it. Like, they show a quick flash of him. And Chopper got some new info. He knows how to, you know, basically he got some kind of information where he can help the kids and escape. Caesar got a plan for, you know, for the Straw Hats, though, and Smoker and them. He says, we're going to shut down Building A, and we're going to, let that smoke in, that killer smoke. And his subordinate says, wait, hold on. He says, we still got some people in there. He says, I don't care, still do it, and make sure you bring a cam. He said, because I want to promote this to the brokers real quick. I bust out laughing, because Caesar is, like I said before, Caesar's a businessman. He said, make sure you promote that, you know, promote our product while you out there killing your own men. That was crazy. He don't care what, he could be in the middle of a Holocaust, get that bread, you know. He said, get this money, do that promotion. That was kind of funny. Virgo, he's like, man, I can't risk a screw up, period. He said, we got a lot riding on this, so I'm going to go out there personally and bust these guys up. He said, where's my sword? I can't, you know, remember where I put them. He said, I'm about to go slice everything up. And Monet is like, you're not a swordsman. He said, oh, yeah, that's right. So this guy really isn't as bright as we think. I think he might either just be forgetful. That might be one of his quirks. Because he doesn't remember, you know, what he ate or stuff getting stuck on his face, stuff like. So I guess he's smart enough, but he just got those quirks. He just forgets he's forgetful or something, or clumsy. Anyway, he wants to fight, so that's good. Luffy and company, they're on the way. In the meanwhile, they're busting up Father. You know, just random, anybody in the way. Spider-Man was on there. He had like some swords and whatnot. Luffy bust that out. G5 is taking their job way too seriously, and they're still going after the Straw Hats and Brown Bear, and they end up getting burned up, frozen, and just plain cut up. You know, Zoro, Tiny Mine, and Brook, they bring it to their front door. They just bring it to them. These guys didn't have a chance. Brown Bear, he's carrying the injured, and they find out why the dragon couldn't fly. They say it was sedated. I think the dragon had a little bit of that candy. Reason why that happened, I believe, Caesar did not want to risk not recreating that devil fruit. He didn't want that devil fruit to escape. That's why that sleigh was full of, you know, apples. And he sedated the gave that dragon some, you know, a treat or whatever to make sure that he didn't fly away with the cart, you know, and everything. And that way when Smiley died, he can make sure he can be assured that he can remake Smiley again, you know. And he's willing to cut through his subordinates to do it. That's how crazy this guy is. Toshigi breaks up the brawl, you know, with Zoro and all them. And Zoro, he's up there laughing. He's like, oh, you're a captain now. I think he looked like he wanted to fight him. And she said, nah, we got to move. We only got a certain amount of time to get out of here. We got to move. So G5 is running. The door's closed. They're trying to hurry up and get there. So the crew is running for their lives again. They back to the funny running again. So in the midst of all this, the door's closing. Everybody's running for their lives. Everybody gets, most of the people get out. And Toshigi gets thrown in there. G5 saved her life. So these guys got some kind of morals with them. They crazy, but they got some kind of morals. And they get hit by the mist. And they get frozen in, you know, in a block of carbonite. So that's pretty much it for that chapter. Everybody, you know, most of the people say Summer G5 got taken out. They're not as fly as they think. Of course, that's a joke, G5. In just case you guys didn't catch that. Anyway, to sum up this chapter, it was okay, but I really didn't enjoy it that much. Reason being because we already got set up. It's just too much setup at this point in time. The pacing is getting a little bit messed up. We already got a good arc in. The arc is good. Go ahead and close it. You know, so we're getting into the thick of things. I mean, it can't be too long now, so I'm not 100% disappointed. But it's like, okay, we already got set up. The only real movement we got in this chapter was Caesar moving everybody to the next building. You know, we see that he's, you know, he's pretty bright. He's able to, you know, think of an idea that can, you know, cut the straw hats off and the pirates off and everything. And it was funny. You know, we got the dragon on dope. We got Caesar, you know, he's doing his business right in the middle of all these people getting slaughtered and everything. We got Virgo, you know, being an idiot. That was kind of just idiotic. I just chuckled, you know. And that's pretty much it, you know, as far as this chapter goes. So I'm not really impressed with it because we already got set up. If this would have been like last week or such and such, it'd be all right, you know. But we already got set up. Let's go ahead, get into the thick of things. Finish this chapter. Last chapter, we got Smoker saying he wanted to fight Virgo. This chapter, we got Virgo saying he wants to fight everybody. So let them fight. You know, let's get ready to rumble. Let's, you know, and we want to see Tiny Mind's son. We want to wrap this up. We want to find out if Monet is working with, you know, what you call him. We want to get Chopper back in the mix and stuff like that. And we want to finish this arc. I mean, it's not much left to this arc anyway. So let's go ahead and finish this up. We had a good run. That's how I feel about it. Another good thing was Jinbei, you know, in the front cover. We see Caribou is, you know, is trying to get, his crew is trying to rescue him. That was another good thing. So we got a few good things, but overall, we got enough set up. That's basically all I can say. We got enough set up. I don't want to see any more set up. Anyway, go ahead and leave your comments. Let me know what you think. Rate the video, subscribe, and I'm out. Peace.